Here's my ride for the week. You've probably seen this all over the internet. The Kia EV9. I guess this blue is popular.
This is Roosevelt with AutoNetwork. I'm behind the wheel of this 2024 Kia. This is the EV9 GT-Line all-wheel drive, long-range, three-row SUV. Let's hop outside and take a walk around and a POV test drive. Let's take a closer look at this three-row 2024 Kia EV9. This is the GT-Line all-wheel drive, long-range, three-row SUV. From the sleek, bold design, Kia has really nailed the futuristic look here. Check out these LED tube projection headlamps. They're sharp and bright, perfect for lighting up any road ahead. And these pixel lights here can also be controlled, give you a different design. And the running lamps are DRLs, adding an extra layer of safety and style while you're on the go. But it's not just about the looks. These active aero flaps right here, they open and close to optimize aerodynamics, improving both performance and efficiency, and cooling the 1,200 pound battery that powers this thing. Check out these 21 inch dark alloy wheels and the wide, when I say wide, 285/45R 21 tires. Sleek, stylish, and ready to tackle anything, whether you're rolling through the city or cruising on the highway. And don't you think they pair perfectly with that ocean blue finish? Now, this profile shows clean lines, modern design, and don't forget those roof rails and the rear spoiler, adding that extra touch of practicality and flair. The EV9 isn't just about looks, though. It's built for adventure with a towing capacity of 5,000 pounds. Now let's check out the rear. And trust me, there's plenty of space back here for all your gear, whether it's a weekend getaway or just a grocery run. As you can see, there's quite a bit of storage space. You have an onboard generator here that you can use to power up. Let's say you're at doing some tailgating and you may want to charge up your electric grill. You can do that. And these seats, third row seats, collapse. Just pull this cord and you can do the same for both seats. Headrest drop there. Now the second row seats are powered. You can control them from this button right here and they fold down. And the neat thing about this, you can also raise them with one button, which is nice. You don't have to go around and raise them from the side. Closing the hatch, just push a button here. And this is the GT line, as I said. You have the GT badging here, have the perpendicular or, well, yeah, the vertical, I'm sorry, LED taillights. I like the fact that they tucked the windshield wiper, rear windshield wiper under here, under that rear spoiler. And the spoiler gives it a nice sporty look. Moving around to the right side, here you have your charger port. Push the button and it opens. And you can have connect to a DC fast charger. Now these door handles recess once you lock the vehicle. And here you have some soft touch materials, some aluminum here, plastic. This is gray. The interior color is a gray. Here you have a different type of cloth material. And this is one of the speakers for the 14 speaker Meridian sound system if you're an audiophile. And to keep the rear cooler and private, you have your privacy shade that comes here. Now we did lower this seat, so we can do this. Push a button, raises that seat, moves it out of the way so you can get in the rear. And what we'll do here, just maybe not. I thought I could. Yeah, I can. I can flip this seat up. Push it back. It's a little hard doing it this way, but it's doable. Slide in the rear. Well, as you can see, I'm sitting in the third row. I have a little bit of leg room here. My knees are up against the seat. I'm about 6'1". Ample headroom. Not much knee room, but I'm sure this second row seat can slide forward slightly. Enough room to take a short trip, but I wouldn't want to be stuck back here for hours. And we can move the seat back just to push up a button right here. As you can see, this is real tight for me. I'm about 6'1". And it's not a lot of leg room back here. So let's push the button here, move the seat forward, see if I can get out gracefully. And in the rear, you have your cup holders, third row seat cup holders, USB-C charging, lots of speakers. You have your own private window here. And it would be nice if it had a panoramic roof, but I'll show you the roof later. It has two separate roof panels. But let's grab the handle here and try and gracefully get out of this thing. And there's another way you can control the seat. There are two ways. You can use this button here to control it. You can also control it from here. Now, there's one thing special about all of these seats. First row, second row, they have a leg rest, passenger rear seats. You have a leg rest that raises here. If I can find the button for it, where is it? There it is, leg rest. You can raise it, move your seat back, give you some room, lower the seat back, and there you have it. Nice reclined position. You have a nice position where you can fully relax. Now, each one of these seats, as I said, has a powered leg rest. I don't know why you want to have it on the driver's seat, but there's one there as well. Now let's move up to the passenger side. Same type of door frame, framing, same types of material. Meridian speaker here, another Meridian speaker, storage pocket, handle grip to close the door. And between the seats, we have some storage space. Show you that later. And here we have the passenger seat, which is nice and comfortable. You have a mesh headrest, which is extremely soft. Two-tone colored seats, as the front passenger, you're not left out in being able to fully recline your position here. And you're in a nice, comfortable position. Take a nap. Let's move back around the front. Now this is a big vehicle. It's about 191 inches long, weighs about 7,000 pounds. The battery itself weighs a little over, I think it's about 1,200 pounds, maybe close to that. But let's take a quick look at the passenger side behind the driver. And again, you have same seats set up. Now the front seats and the rear seats have pockets for storage. Sliding in here, you have storage bin here. Slides out, little ambient lighting. Open it, nice deep storage. Cup holders. And I love the design shape of this, like I said, this headrest. You have plenty of vents for cooling in the rear. You have your controls here for your AC. Turn that on. You can control it from the rear. And the rear seats are heated and ventilated. So they're heated and cooled. This breaks up the monotony of a long journey. And again, your rear passengers or your passengers will love that feature. Now let's go to where everything is controlled. The driver's side. Here you have the driver's door panel. Have the controls for heating and cooled seats, position of each one of the drivers, window controls, mirror controls. Again, this is the gray interior. Door handle there, Meridian speaker. I like these foot pedals. Deadpan, all metal. You have your EV9 badging on your floor mats. You have the controls here to open your front, the rear. And here, like, and you want to take a break, like I said before, you turn on your mood music. Hit the button here. Steering wheel raises out of the way. Seat back and seat lowers. The leg rest comes up, and you can just take them back, take a break, enjoy the music, relax, get ready to hit the road again. Once you're ready to hit the road, hit the button again, and it will do the reverse. Put you back in your original seating position. And you're ready to continue your journey. But let's slide into the driver's side. Now, here comes that one thing that I told you I really don't like. Start-stop button is down here on the stalk. Terrible location as far as I'm concerned. But other than that, I couldn't find anything wrong with this car. You have your controls here on the steering wheel. You have your drive mode button. Change to different drive modes. You have normal, sport, my drive, which is customizable, snow, and eco. Put it back in sport. Over here, you have your controls for your cruise control, distance between the car in front of you with adaptive cruise control. Some buttons here to give you a different look at the 12.3 inch gauge. This thing has a nav, what is that, a compass. So if you want to know which direction you're going in. Now this has two 12.3 inch screens. One is for the instrument cluster, and you have another one here for the infotainment and navigation system. And you have some buttons along here where they're really icons. I guess they are buttons. You can hit, that's the map. Go to home, go back here. We don't have any media. Let's go to setup. This is one I like. One of the features that I think you really should pay attention to is the conditioning of the battery. Utility mode, smart generation, regeneration. You can control regeneration with paddles here on the steering column. Now let's go back to the settings here. We can go in, you have your nav system, you have your sound. Now, if you have been out on, you've had a rough day at the office, you come out to your car, you can hop in the back seat of this thing, recline the seat, turn on some ambient mood music for the moment, and just wind down before you head out and get into the traffic for the day. And it has a series of different music, different types of music. So you pick what you like and just sit back, think about the long day, or don't think about anything. And you can do that as a passenger in the front passenger seat. You can do it in the rear, a rear passenger, these seats recline. And if you're sitting in the rear and you need more space from the seat up front here, you can push a button and the seat moves forward, give you that extra room so that you can stretch your legs out in the back and really enjoy this EV9 on the road. The other thing, being on the road, it's going to be nice and comfortable and smooth. 7,000 pounds, it's kind of hard to bounce this thing around. Excellent suspension system. And here you have a large glove box, and that's actually hard to move. Now, one other thing, it has, the rearview mirror is also a digital camera, so you can get a different look as to what's behind you. And let's take a look at the sunroof. You have a power sunroof. And you also have a control for the, where is it? Here we go. The second sunroof, which is the shade control. So you have two sunroofs. Like I said before, I would prefer a panoramic single glass roof to really open up the interior of this EV9. All right, let's hop outside, check out what's under the hood, if you can call it a hood. I think we call it a frunk. And where's the button for it? Somewhere down here. There we go. Double click. Let's move around to the front. Open up the frunk. And as you can see, there's not a whole lot of space under there. As a matter of fact, this is the case, which is nice looking, just for the charging cable itself. Now, if you take that out, put it in the back, you may be able to get a soft side two-day duffel bag, maybe. Now, the interior of this EV9, the material that you saw was what's called a syntex. It's not real leather, but it wears well, it looks well, it feels well, it's very comfortable. And the steering wheel that you saw, it's heated and wrapped in that syntex. Now, this EV9 is powered, this is the GT line, It's powered by a dual motor all-wheel drive system that delivers 379 horsepower at 516 pound-feet of torque. The battery is a 99.8 kilowatt hour battery, and like I said, it weighs a little over 1200 pounds, which adds obviously to the weight of the vehicle. As you know, EVs are heavy. This is a 7,000 pound vehicle. Now, if you're ready to make a switch to an electric three-row SUV that does it all, this EV9 should be one for you. I can't say enough about this car. I've been behind the wheel for a couple days now, and I'm going to take you out on a POV drive in just a minute. Oh, I forgot. The key fob. It has a hold button where you can start this car. And if you're in a tight parking space, you can move it forward and you can move it in reverse with just using the key fob. You don't have to try and squeeze in and ding your doors.
I'm out to the EV9. Now I'm gonna have it to back up, hopefully. How do you like this? Come to me, come to me, come to me, come to me. Love that feature. Let's try a fast start from zero and see what this thing does. Is that quick or what?
We're gonna head out and take a POV test drive of this 2024. This is the Kia EV9 GT-Line all-wheel drive, long-range, three-row SUV. And as I mentioned earlier in the video, this thing has a 99.8 kilowatt-hour battery, weighs about 1,200 pounds, gets 379 horsepower at 516 pound-feet of torque. Later on, I'll do a 0 to 60 see how long it takes. Kia says about 5 seconds. This is one big automobile, and I don't know whether you notice the doors, but the doors are huge on this thing. And it has a lot of interior space. And like I mentioned earlier, the front seats as well as the second row passenger seats fully recline, and they have individual leg rests, which is just a little different. So Kia has spent a lot of time, energy, design, and engineering brain power to come up with a three-row SUV that I think will compete with anything that's out there on the market. Now, mind you, when you say Kia, you don't think $78,000, but that's what this particular model that I'm driving has, or is priced at. It's $78,000. But I think once you go out to the dealership, find a dealer that has one, take it out for a test drive, and you will be just as impressed as I am. And I think that they have hit the nail on the head, as they say, with a sledgehammer.
Now, this EV9 has cameras. When you turn on the signal, whether it's left or right, you can see what's on the left side, and you can see what's on the right side. Now, this EV9 does have a pretty good heads-up display. You may be able to see it there in the shade of the overpass.